We happy few. We band of brothers. Were you united in the belief that any honorably discharged veteran shall have military honors if the family so desires? Our service is a traditional one. We have a eulogy. We have a prayer by our chaplain. Then we have three volleys from the rifles. The first volley represents John's birth. The second volley represents John's time in the service. And the third volley represents John's passing. Then we will have tats. For those of you that served in the military, you know tats signifies the end of the day, the end of the work day. For John, his work in this life is complete. When the call of our country was heard, John answered, self forgotten in the cause of the greater good. As a brave man, he marched away with an abiding faith in his God, his country, and his flag. The red of our country's flag was made redder still by his heroism, the white more stainlessly pure by the mode which impelled him. And in the starry field of our nation's glorious banner, the blue has been glorified by the service he has given for American ideals. The chaplain will now invoke the divine blessing.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, Father of all, in the depth of our sorrow, we realize the truth of the inspired words. I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. As patriot after patriot departs this life, we march on with ranks grown thinner. Help us to be faithful unto thee and to one another. We beseech thee, look in mercy upon all of us assembled here, and with thine own tenderness, console and comfort those bereaved by the hand of death. Give them the oil of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. Heavenly Father, bless our country with freedom, peace, and righteousness, and through thy sovereign and Holy Spirit's favor, may we all meet at last before thy throne of grace in heaven, and to thy great name shall be praised forever and ever.
John, he was a veteran of the Second World War. There were 16.5 million men and women that served at that time. And before the war, they survived the Great Depression, and they went on to defeat the Nazis, the fascists, and the imperialists. Then they came home and built the country that we know today. As Tom Brokaw said, they are the greatest generation. They are the greatest generation. And World War II has been over with now for 73 years. And every day we are being called upon to fulfill these sad and these respect for our departed comrades. The present, full of the cares that beset all nations, whether engaged in war or peace, fades away as we look back on the day John left his home to defend his country. Imbued by a spirit of devotion and inspired by an undying love of his native land, he gladly went forth and joined with comrades both young and old to help preserve our heritage of freedom. We trust the example set by John will prove a beacon to the youth of our country, who also be called upon to uphold the honor of our flag. As years roll on, we too shall have finished our fight, shall be laid to rest, and our souls follow the long column to the realms above, as an all-holding death, hour by hour, shall mark his recruits. Let us so live that when the keeper of the eternal records calls our names for the last time, those we leave behind may say of us, as we now say of John, here lies all that is immortal of a true-hearted comrade and a fearless defender of his country and his flag. We're moving on now to the rifle volleys and taps. When taps are being played, the honor guard will render a final salute in honor of John. If you'd like to join us in that salute, that is by giving the civilian salute, which will be formed by rising, if you are able, placing the right hand over the heart. This is during the sounding of taps. If there are any veterans in attendance, you're authorized by an act of Congress to give a military hand salute at that time. Officer today, on display of colors, prepare the rifle team for a three-volley salute and task.
Yes, sir.
freedoms, my freedoms,